Betty, and this is Everyday Jesus, a program specially made for you wonderful kids because we know you love to worship, to study, and learn the Word of God. Now, can you do it with Pastora? Let's say to worship, to study, and learn the Word of God. Great job, kids. Now, to begin, we will start with a prayer. Can I see your prayer magnets?
Yes!
And let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this wonderful day that you have given us. I pray that you will give us wisdom and understanding so that we will be able to apply all of the things that we will be learning today. We love you so much, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen! He's the best! So right now, let's all stand up and let's worship with Everyday Jesus!
In Psalm 103, verse 1, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. So that is what we are going to do, kids. We are going to bless and praise the name of our God.
Amen.
With all that we are. So let's open up our hearts and let's worship Him and let's sing this song. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, I worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I worship Your holy name.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Let's sing it once again.
Our praise and worship time with Pastors Pam and Gary. And I also know you know what time is it, right? It's our Bible story time. So please get your Bibles, your notebooks, and of course, your favorite pens. And once you have them all with you, can you help us to remember rule time for today? Rule number one, hands behave. Rule number two, eyes watchful. Rule number three, ears listening. And rule number four, mouth silent. Great job, kids. Now for our Bible story for today, we will be opening our Bibles to Acts chapter 5, verses 33 to 42. Now, kids, can you please get your Bibles and open it to Acts chapter 5, verses 33 to 42? And let's read. When they heard this, they were enraged and wanted to kill them. But a Pharisee in the council named Gamaliel, a teacher of the law, held in honor by all the people, stood up and gave orders to put the men outside for a little while. And he said to them, "Men of Israel, take care of what you are about to do with these men, for before these days, Judas rose up claiming to be somebody, and a number of men, about 400, joined him. He was killed, and all who followed him were dispersed and came to nothing. After him, Judas the Galilean rose up in the days of the census and drew away some of the people after him. He too perished, and all who followed him were scattered. So, in the present case, I tell you, keep away from this man and let them alone, for if this plan or this undertaking is of man, it will fail. But if it is of God, you will not be able to overthrow them. You might even be found opposing God." So they took his advice, and when they had called in the apostles, they beat them and charged them not to speak in the name of Jesus, and then let them go. Then they left the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer dishonor for the name. And every day in the temple and from house to house, they did not cease teaching and preaching that the Christ is Jesus. Wow, amazing Bible story, right, kids? We have seen that nothing can stop the apostles from meeting together, preaching and teaching the word of God. Every day, wherever they went, whether in the temple or house to house, they declared the good news. Today, aside from the church, we can also teach and learn the word of God house to house through our Go groups or Bible studies. Awesome, right? So right now, can you follow Pastora in these very simple action words? Can we say, "I can also learn God's word in my house"? Can we do it again? Can we say, "I can also learn God's word in my house"? Now can we do it the last time, kids? Can we say, "I can also learn God's word in my house"? Great job, kids! So right now, I know you know what time is it, right? It's our question and answer time. So please get your notebooks and of course your pens. And you can always write down the correct answers so that once we're back in children's church, we can give you extra tickets for every correct answers. So, are you ready? Great! So now let's go to our question number one. Who were unstoppable in sharing the gospel? Who were unstoppable in sharing the gospel? Done, kids? Great job. So now let's go to our question number two. True or false? The apostles taught the gospel in the temple and house to house. True or false? The apostles taught the gospel in the temples and house to house. Done, kids? Awesome! So now let's go to our question number three. Fill in the blank. I can also learn God's word in my... I can also learn God's word in my... Done, kids? Very good job. So right now, let's go to our question number four, which is, of course, our application for today. Kids, let us desire to open our houses as a place where we can learn the Word of God and experience His miracles and blessings. Now, don't forget, kids, to ask your mommies and daddies if you can have a Go group or a Bible study in your houses today. So, I think that's it for our Bible story for today, kids. And I hope you learn a lot. We'll see you again next time, kids!
And this is Good Kids Tips, where you will learn tips on how to be good kids. Very good, because Jesus wants you to be good. And all the good kids say,
Amen!
Amen! Today, we will learn a tip about being good kids from our story. Are you ready? Good kids join and participate in a Bible study. In our Bible story, we see that the believers never stop learning the Word of God as they meet together from house to house through their Bible studies. The disciples did not stop teaching and preaching Jesus every day in the temple and from house to house. But you might think, Pastora, how can we have a Bible study in our homes during lockdown? You know what, kids? We have lots of Bible studies for you. And these kids are meeting. Some of them in their homes because there are lots of kids in their houses, and some of them through online. Now, let's watch some of our friends that are attending the Bible studies and see what are the things that they are doing in a Bible study. Are you ready? First, we see our friends participating in a Bible study by praying with other kids together. Wow! How about this one? What do you see? That's right! Kids are clapping their hands and enjoying as they worship together with other kids. And lastly, what do you see that our friend is doing? Yes, that's right. Our friend is reading the Bible as his leader asked him to read the verse. Awesome, right? So, did you see that, kids? There are lots of things that you can do in a Bible study together with other kids. So, if you are not yet part of a Bible study, tell your pastors so we can join you to the kids' Bible study that we have near you. Because once again, good kids join and participate in a Bible study. I hope you learned a lot from our good kid tip today. Remember, God wants you to be good so you can praise your Father in heaven. See you again next time!
Hi kids! So today, we are going to sing a song about Jesus being our friend. That's right! Is Jesus your friend? Me too! Jesus is my friend. Now, did you know that when we are sad, Jesus helps us? Well, what more when we are happy? Jesus rejoices also with us. Now, today, are you ready to sing the song with me? So come on, let's all stand up and let's sing the song together.
What a friend we have.
That's right! Our Jesus is our friend, and anything that we have, we always lay it before the Lord. That's right! So, that's it for our song for today. I hope that you've enjoyed that song. God bless!
Hi kids! I am AJ, your everyday Jesus tour guide. And together, we will go play fair and learn more about the Bible. Welcome to the Bible Ventures. Today, we are here at the Western Wall. It is an ancient limestone wall in the old city of Jerusalem. Some people call it the Wailing Wall, because of the Jews weeping and crying when the temple was destroyed. Do you know how long is this wall? According to Google, it's 1,601 feet. Wow, that's very long. But the part that is visible to all the Western Wall Plaza is just 70 meters of it. People go here to pray, and some of them bring small papers with prayer requests and put it in the wall. Wow! It is in this place where God says that His eyes and ears will always be. Wow! Amazing! Look! here are some pictures of our friends at the Western Wall. I hope you learned something today. Someday, we will go there to pray. All right? See you again next time here at Tantara Bible Ventures.
Hi, kids. I have an exciting game for you today in our Bible game segment. I am Pastora Francis, and today I'm going to check how much you have learned from our Bible stories this past week. I'm going to ask a few questions, and you can choose your answers from the choices that follow. You can send your answers to any of our kids' pastors, or you can post your comments in this video, and we will give you points for every correct answer. Are you ready?
Yes!
Let's go!
Question number 1. Hebrews 10:25 teaches us that we should not neglect the habit of A. Eating together, B. Thinking together, C. Meeting together, or D. Playing together. The correct answer is C. We should not neglect the habit of meeting together because when we do, Jesus meets with us. Question number 2. True or false? We need to be in a big congregation for Jesus to be with us. The correct answer is false. We learn in Matthew 18 verses 19 to 20 that even when two or three people gather in the name of Jesus, He is there. Question number 3. One of the ways that we can meet together with other believers is to A. Join a Bible study, B. Join in a school competition, C. Attend a birthday party, D. Watch my favorite movie with my friends. The correct answer is A. Join a Bible study. When we gather with other believers, the focus of our activity should be only Jesus. Question number 4. During the time of Jesus, how often did people go to church? A. Every year, B. Every month, C. Every week, D. Every day. The correct answer is D. Every day. We find in Acts 2:46 that the believers continued to meet together every day in the temple courts. Question number 5. What do believers do when they meet together? A. Worship, B. Pray, C. Study the Word of God, or D. All of the above. The correct answer is all of the above. When believers meet together, we spend time worshiping God, praying for one another, and learning God's Word together.
Wow, that was an awesome game, kids. I hope that you enjoyed today's Bible game segment. Remember to send your answers to your kids' pastors, or you can post them in the comments section in this video so that we can give you points for your correct answers. Once again, I'm Pastora Francis. Till next time!
Hi kids, this is Pastora Armira. Are you ready to learn a new memory verse song today? Yes, our verse for today is 1 Corinthians 3 verse 16. Repeat after me. Say 1 Corinthians 3 verse 16. Very good. And the song goes something like this.
Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? God's Spirit lives in you. Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? God's Spirit lives in you. Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? God's Spirit lives in you. Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? God's Spirit lives in you. Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? God's Spirit lives in you. Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? God's Spirit lives in you. Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? Don't you know that you are God's temple? God's Spirit lives in you. God's Spirit lives in you. God's Spirit lives in you.
Yay! Very good, kids. Did you enjoy that song? I did too. Well, that's it for our memory verse song today. This is Pastora Armira. See you again next time!
Welcome back, kids! So I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot from our episode today. So right now, it's our prayer time. Do you still remember our three prayer requests?
Yes!
First, we will be praying for our government and church leaders alike, that God will always give them wisdom and understanding so that they can always make the best decisions for the people. Second, we will be praying for your families, that God will always keep them safe, and that God will always bless the work of the hands of your parents. And third, we will be praying for you, wonderful kids. What do you want Jesus to do for you? Now, as for us, you know our prayer request for you always is that you will continuously grow in the fear and the knowledge of the Lord. You will always be productive, and you will always be a blessing to the people around you. So are you ready to pray, kids?
Yeah!
Let's have our prayer magnets, and let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this wonderful day and from all of the things that we have learned. Right now, we pray for our government and church leaders alike, that God, you will always give them wisdom and understanding so that they can always make the best decisions for the people. Lord, I pray for our families, that you will always keep our family safe and away from all kinds of harm and sicknesses, and that you will always bless the work of the hands of our parents. And Lord, right now I pray for these wonderful kids, that you will always make them grow in the fear and the knowledge of the Lord, that they will always be productive in everything that they do, and that they will always be a blessing to the people around them. Thank you so much, Lord, and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. He's the best. So that's it, kids, for Everyday Jesus today. We'll see you again next time.